Good morning, boys and girls. It is Thursday, May 14th, 2020. Only one more day till our cookie party. I am so excited to get to see your smiling faces and get to do the cookie party. I apologize. I look so tired. I am exhausted. I was working in the classroom for 10 hours today, trying to get everything packed up and get all your bags ready and all the classrooms. So tomorrow we'll be having our show and tell from the classroom. It will be the last time we'll be in the classroom. So if you'd like to see the classroom one more time, tomorrow would be the day that you want to join me for show and tell at 11. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started with our day. Today is C for calm down to second grade. So hopefully you guys got lots of exercise in today or yesterday. I'm sorry. Today is craft day. So you can make a craft or two. Use materials you already have at your house. Be creative. Maybe you make something from nature. Maybe you make something that you've always wanted to do at your house. So try to be creative. I'd love to see them on Flipgrid or post them on a homeroom or you can put them in your Google Classroom. So, okay, let's go ahead and get practice with our sound practice. Here we go. Ready? Let's go ahead and present this so we can see it a little better. I am going to open the door because my cat is scratching at the door. And she is very loud. So, ready? Let's go ahead and say the ending and say the card and the sound, right? Nch, ong. It, at, f, per, et, stir, ing, ang, sh, r, ung. Okay, get your hands ready. Let's tap out our words. Now remember, this has no consonants afterwards, so this is going to be open syllables, so that open post note right here is going to be the long I sound. Here we go. Ch. I, chai. Ooh, chai tea, different spelling though. Ch-ong, chong, not a word. Ch-ang, chang, not a word, but it can be a name. So that would have to make this proper noun, which would be capital. N-ang, nang, not a word. Ooh, look at open syllable. What am I going to say? I'm going to say the U sound. N-new, new. Ooh, that is a word, but is that how I would spell it? No. N-usp, nusp, not a word. Full-usp, flusp, not a word. Full-ung, full-ulk, flulk, not a word. D-w-ulk, d-w-ulk, not a word. D-w-ilk, d-wilk, not a word. B-ilk, bilk, not a word. Ooh, look at open syllable. B, I, bi. Ooh, bi is a word, but what would it be spelled like? So it would be by, like I went by the tree. Or you could have buy, which is like when you buy something at the store. B, ung, bung, not a word. B, ing, bing, not a word. R, ing, ring, that is a word. Sh, ing, shring, shing, not a word. Stirring, string, that is a word. Okay, guys, so let's go ahead and jump into our syllables. Today we're going to be talking about compound words. Compound words are two separate words. When you put them together, make a different one. So we're going to look for our vowels first. Oh, here's our vowel. Ooh, look at what I see. I see a diphthong, which means those two vowels are going to change the sound. So this is going to be just like our loud clown. And then I have another vowel over here. Oh, look at that. I see a W next to it. So this is either going to say O or ow. O or ow. And that is also going to be a diphthong. Doesn't English have funny words? Okay, so let's see. So then we have consonant. 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 So where do I want to divide this? I want to divide it after the second consonant. So remember, when I have three consonants, I'm going to divide it after the second consonant. Okay, so ready? Let's go ahead and tap this out. Count. Count. Ooh, you know what? I think I should keep this together as a blend. What do you think? just like that. Because we just practiced those blends. Okay, ready? Count. Oop. Count. Down. Down. Count down. Compound word. Two words, two separate words. Bring them together. They make one brand new word. Countdown. Okay, let's look for our vowels. I have a vowel here. And I have a vowel. Oh, look at, I have an O right next to the U. That means that's going to be a diphthong. And I see a CK next to each other. What do I have to do with CK? I got to keep them together. Okay, so I see a vowel, consonant, vowel. Okay, so normally I divide it after the first vowel, just like our lion words, right? Or I'm sorry, our tiger words. So let's try this. Ready? This is open. Ch, e, chi, k, out, kout, chi, kout. Ooh, does that work? Nope, doesn't make sense. So now, remember, if it doesn't make sense, I go and divide it after the consonant. So let's try this now. This changes this from an open to a closed syllable. Here we go. Ch, ek, check, out, out. Check out. Is check out a word? Yes, it's a compound word. Two separate words put together to make one word. Okay, let's try the next one. Looking for my vowels first. Oop, look at that. I see. Oops. I see a vowel next to W, so that's going to be a diphthong. That's either going to say O or ow. And then I see another vowel, but I see a vowel team. Those stay together. The O and the A say what? They say O. Okay, so I see a consonant and a consonant. So if I have two consonants, what do? Break it in the middle. Okay, here we go. Ready? Down, down, load, load, download. You guys download all the time. You download music or download pictures or download documents. Downloading means when you take a file and you put it permanently onto a space. So like a computer or iPod or iPad and things like that. So, okay, so this week our word well words were house. We have the ow sound and a silent E. We have the word eight. Remember the E-I-G-H makes the A sound. Only, move, and learn. And you're going to go ahead and write those words in pencil, marker, and crayons. If you already know how to spell these words without looking, go ahead and challenge yourself. Okay, so today we're going to actually watch a brain pop about spring. And after the video, we're going to answer some questions. So I want you to think about the questions. Remember, this is a tip, is that you can listen about questions, listens to the questions before you start, so that way you know what the author is going to be asking you. So what is spring weather like? What happens to plants during spring? What happens to animals during spring? And what do people do in springtime? And then a bonus question down here is, what is your favorite thing to do in spring? I thought this was a perfect one for all of our beautiful spring weather.
Finally, it's spring. That means winter is over. What is spring weather like? Spring is the season between winter and summer. In most places, spring is warmer than winter, but cooler than summer. In the spring, the days are longer than in the winter, and there are more hours of sunlight. Spring days in some places can be sunny and warm. Right, Moby. Some areas get rain in the spring. There's an old saying about spring weather. April showers bring May flowers. In the spring, there can be strong storms. Some places might get tornadoes. A tornado is a spinning tube of air that moves really fast along the ground. As spring gets closer to summer, the weather gets warmer and warmer in most places. In the beginning of spring, I usually wear light sweaters and pants. But by the end of spring, I might wear t-shirts and shorts. When is spring? It takes 1 year for Earth to orbit or go around the sun. Our planet is tilted at an angle. Earth's tilt and orbit cause the seasons to change. The equator is an imaginary line around the middle of the Earth. On March 20th, the sun shines directly on the equator, and the lengths of day and night are almost equal. This marks the start of spring. Spring ends around June 20th, but a lot of people consider March, April, and May as the spring months. What happens to plants during the spring? In some places, the ground freezes in winter. Many plants stop growing. When the weather gets warmer, the ground thaws or melts. Many plants start growing again. In the spring, seeds sprout and grow. Trees grow leaves and buds, which will bloom into flowers. Flowers grow and bloom. During spring, there's more food for animals. What happens to animals during the spring? Some animals migrate to warmer places for the winter. They migrate back in the spring. Animals that have been hibernating through the winter start moving around again in the spring. Bees and other insects come out too. Cool! That bird is building a nest. In the spring, most birds lay eggs, and later, they hatch. Many animals have their young in the spring because food is plentiful. What do people do in springtime? I like spring because we get to spend more time outdoors. People go on picnics, ride bikes, or go to baseball games. Spring is a good time for things to grow. Our family plants a garden in spring. What are you planting, Moby? Pizza seeds. Arbor Day is a special day in spring when people plant trees. It's a chance to help the community and learn about how our forests are changing. Earth Day is also celebrated in the spring. We learn how our planet is changing and find out what we can do to help the environment. Spring is a time for things to grow and change. I picked some flowers for you, Moby.
Okay, so spring is quickly in full swing here, and we have a very lucky area because we actually get to experience all four seasons that our seasons change. If we lived in a different area in the United States and even the world, we would sometimes only get to experience a really mild change. So what is spring weather like? What do you think? I think spring weather can change quickly and is mild, which means it's not too hot and it's not too cold. Like she said in the video, sometimes at the beginning of spring, she wears long sleeves and pants. And then by the end of spring, into early June, you're able to wear shorts. What happens to plants during spring? In spring, plants start to grow. Just like our apple trees that we talked about, how they are like in hibernation, they begin to grow. What happens to animals during the spring? Lots of baby animals are born, and some animals come out of hibernation? What do people do in the springtime? Well, what's something you really enjoy? If it wasn't the COVID-19 time, what would you really enjoy doing spring? Well, in our household, we love to play baseball and softball during spring. And what is your favorite thing to do in spring? I do not like that text. It's in all capitals. That's not okay. There we go. I'm going to move this guy up. To do in spring is go for a bike ride. In spring is go for a bike ride. And we love doing that as a family. Okay, from Cuckoo Kangaroo today, it's called Dino Stomp. Cuckoo Kangaroo today. It's called Dino Stomp. Hope that you were enjoying that as much as I was. I love the Dino Stomp. What time is it? Time to get a watch. Okay, so let's go ahead and take a look at our story for this week. This is our decodable series. So we should be able to read this pretty easily and with expression when we're reading. So today we're going to be reading the story called Signs of Change. The sun beams brightly. Ice melts from every house. People are more cheerful. No one minds the mild air. Ooh, we use that word mild in our brain pop writing. Most trees turn gold and red. It's time to learn again. Some are joyful as they enter. Others move slowly. So this is spring. Everything's kind of popping up. And now everything's starting to kind of slow down again. And it looks like they're getting ready to go back to school. I'm hoping we go back to school in the fall. The wind blows wild and cold. 8 inches of snow fall. Only the bold go out in that way. How can they find their way? So let's go back through and let's read each page and then we're going to look. So it says read the story and highlight the two words with suffixes. Remember, a suffix is at the end of the word. It's going to change the root word just slightly. Signs of change. The sun beams brightly. Ice melts from every house. Okay, which one has that suffix? Well, I see the root word bright and ly. There we go. People are more cheerful. No one minds the mild air. Okay, so when you have another word with a suffix, cheerful means full of cheer. Okay. We are now circling the two words that have the long O spelling. Okay. Most trees, oh, they already gave us one. That was so fast. Most trees turn gold. Oh, there's another one. Well, let's see if there's any more. Maybe they missed a couple. And red, it's time to learn again. Some are joyful as they enter. Others move more slowly. Ooh, lots of O words, but not any ones that just spelled with an O. Slowly is the O sound, but it's spelled with the O-W. This one says I'm going to spell, highlight two words that have the long I with the I sound. So like mild and wild, which means that I is just on its own is the reason why it says the long I. The wind blows wild. Oh, there's one right away. And cold. 8 inches of snow fall. Only the bold will go out in that. How can they find their way? Oh, there's that find. Awesome. Okay, so we are actually going to flip-flop our math and our writing today. And today we are going to be using mental math to find 10 less on a number. Hunter Shark.
You have used different ways to subtract tens. Find 35 minus 10. You can use a model to help. How do the blocks show that you subtracted 35 minus 10?
Sorry, guys, I had to grab my charger. So how can you use models to help you with the blocks that show you how to subtract 35 minus 10? Well, you can think of that you're taking away one group of 10.
First, they show three tens rods and five ones cubes for 35. Then they show that one 10, or 10, is subtracted by crossing out one of the tens rods. How does the 100 chart show that you subtracted 35 minus 10?
What do we do
on the circle is drawn around the number 35. Then an arrow goes up one row to 25. Both ways show the same answer. 35 minus 10 equals 25. You can also use mental math to subtract 10. What is the tens digit in the number 35?
Which one is it?
The tens digit in 35 is 3. What is the tens digit in the number 10? The tens digit in 10 is 1. What basic fact do you know that can help you find 35 minus 10?
Well, you do 3 minus 1. You sure can. That will tell you how many groups of 10 you have left.
You can use the basic fact 3 minus 1 equals 2. So, 35 minus 10 equals 25. When you subtract 10, the tens digit goes down by 1. Subtract 10 from these numbers.
Okay, let's go ahead and try it. We're doing mental math. Okay, 46 minus 10. I want you to point at the screen. Which one should I pick? Remember, we're only changing the tens digit. We're going to go down by 1. So I see 6 is in the 1 space. So you tell me when I get to it. Yep, right there. Okay, 78 minus 10, I'm going to keep my ones place the same. So I'm going to be looking for an 8 in the ones place, but my 10 has to go down by 1. You tell me when I get to it. Yep, right there. Okay, 95 minus 10. Let's see, our ones place is going to stay the same. We're going to go down by 110, right there, 85.
46 minus 10 equals 36. 78 minus 10 equals 68. 95 minus 10 equals 85. In each of these problems, which digit changes in the differences?
Did my ones ever change? Look at 6, 6, 8, 8. 5, 5. It doesn't change. Which digit changes? It's going to be the tens digit.
The tens digit decreases by 1. The ones digit stays the same. Why is that? The tens digits always decrease by 1 because you are subtracting 1 10. The ones digit always stays the same because 10 has 0 ones. So no ones are being subtracted.
Remember, when subtracting tens, the tens digit changes, but not the ones digit.
Okay, so I want to take a look and just do some mental math, okay? So 85 minus 10, what does that equal? Well, 1 less than 8 is 7, so I know it's going to be 75. What about 67 minus 10? Let's do some mental math. I know 6 minus 1 is 5, so it's 5 groups of 10, so that's going to be 57. Let's see. Ooh, let's bet this. 110 minus 10. Well, I'm going to take away a group of 10s. So this means I would have 0 10s, but I still have a group of 100. So that would be the number 100. So I'd just like you to mentally try to do some of these with, let's do 45 minus 10, 27 minus 10, and let's do 86 minus 10. Now, if you need some harder numbers, try to pick some hundreds, like 150 minus 10, or if you want some really hard numbers, maybe do like 268 minus 10. But you guys can even go harder than that. Okay, so today for writing, you don't have to do any new writing, but I wanted to point it out something to you guys. So this was my story from the other day. And what I'm noticing is that you guys are doing a really great job giving me an order of things. But what a lot of you guys are giving me, and that's okay because we're just learning, so you're still cool, is you're giving me a list. When I do a procedural writing, it is not a list. Okay. You won't have numbers telling what is next. That's still the procedures, but when you're doing procedural writing, you're using some of those transition words with full sentences. So let's say if I was to read this and I said, if I did something I don't want to do, I would say, first one, she gets her materials. Two, she plants the seeds. Three, she waters her seeds. Four, her plant, her beautiful plant grows tall. So I have a nice list here, but when I'm writing procedural writing, I want to make sure I'm using complete sentences and I want to use those transitional words. I'm actually building a paragraph, guys. So we don't want to, see if I have one. And like I said, it's okay because we're just learning how to do these. Do I have one? I do not. That's okay. So I don't want to do the numbers where I'm actually counting through and kind of adding this up. Oh, there's one. Okay, so this is not what I want to do. Okay, I'm actually building a paragraph. So like right here, I have my items, okay? So I might even start with my opening sentence, which I didn't put in my procedure. So I might say, today I am going to grow a plant. Now I'm going to start with my procedure. First, she is going to, because otherwise it doesn't make sense. So first, she gets her materials together. Next, see, I'm not putting those numbers. I'm actually writing the complete sentences with the transition words. Next, she plants the seeds. Then she waters her seeds. Finally, her beautiful plant grows tall. So you can see that this is the exact same information. It's just framed differently. Okay. So I just wanted to point that out to you guys so you can pay attention to that, that you want to make sure that when we're doing those procedural writing, we're not making just a list. We're actually putting complete thoughts together so that we can put it into a paragraph if we wanted to. Okay. So what you need to do with the video now is you're going to do the word well sort. And then today is C for craft day. So I would love for you guys to build a craft, make a craft. It might be a craft from outside. It might be a craft inside. This is Wednesday night. I'm recording this. On Thursday, it's supposed to rain. So it might be kind of a bad day to get some nature things. I want you to do 15 minutes of Lexia. We have our 150 Lexia party, guys, coming up because you guys got to keep passing those levels. Read your book from Mrs. Howell. It's really important. Those are challenge books, guys, this week, and I know you can do it. Go ahead and listen to Mrs. Howell's read aloud. Your special today is PE, and then make sure you do your group form for Thursday. So I hopefully we'll see you guys. Oh, I should probably put that on here. See you at 11 o'clock for show and tell. And remember, show and tell today is going to be a free show and tell, and I will be in the classroom at 11 o'clock. Okay. So I miss you guys so much. I cannot wait to see your smiling faces on Friday. I am so excited to deliver those cookies to you. And I miss you guys so incredibly much. I love you guys, and I will talk to you soon. Bye, guys.